There are hundreds of animals who call the natural state home. But farmers say one animal has overstayed its welcome.
They're a whole lot like that Tasmanian devil. He used to be on Looney Tunes. They just tear everything up.
He's talking about feral hogs.
They're not afraid of anything. They run off our game that we hunt, deer in the woods, or have had a few turkeys, but they run everything off. The bully of the woods, I guess.
They have a big appetite, leaving behind a slop for farmers.
They're destroying our crop, and they're a nuisance on pipelines that we lay out for soybeans.
Scott Mines and his brother Dean have been farming in Stuttgart their entire life.
Well, it's kind of in our blood, so that's what we do.
They harvest rice, wheat, and soybeans in Arkansas County.
This is a rice field. Spots that you see are damaged from hogs.
A crop duster captured the mess left behind from the hogs.
It's just unbelievable how much they had damaged.
And you can see where they turned these soybean crops into a buffet.
You can see in the roads where they come in at night and waller around, make holes, tear stuff up.
It's a similar story for Brooks Davis.
Destructive. It doesn't matter what it is. They take out all the food for all the other wildlife. They run the deer off.
Davis says the hogs have caused him to lose money.
About every spring, $8,000 to $10,000 in just seeds to replant. Not the time lost, not the yield lost, but just in the seeds to replant.
We followed game and fish to an area in Woodruff County that had a corral trap set up. The trap works through an app.
It's all automated. It's like got a live feed video system here on it.
When it comes to controlling hogs in your area, trapping them is the most effective method. But Davis believes there are other ways.
We need some kind of poison. Now, I realize they don't want to poison because of the predators, but, you know, maybe the rabbits and songbirds, they could probably use a break from some of those predators, too.
Game and Fish says toxicants are illegal, and there's no magical solution to the problem.
We'd be bad stewards of the land if a product did not undergo good scientific research and go through a good vetting process. Toxicant seems really, really easy till we get down into the technical administration of a toxicant. It's, you know, how is this bait going to be placed on the ground?
As the hunt continues for hogs, farmers are just hoping to catch a break.
A big nuisance.
Anything we can, because we just despise them.